Hello, everybody. Welcome back to American Textbook Reading Series. I'm your host, Brian Stewart. Today, we're looking at Science Book, Unit 3, and the title of the unit is Growth and Change. You will discover in this unit how animals and plants grow and change, and also what life cycles are. So, as always, let's begin with the vocabulary section. Okay, our first word is germinate. Whew, it's a big word. Germinate. Three syllables. Germinate. Germinate means to start growing for a seed. When a seed is put into the ground, it'll start growing. I wonder what that looks like. Well, we have a picture here. You see the seed, it starts growing, but we also have a video. Let's take a look. As we can see, you can see the plants beginning to grow. Some of them, it seems like they're popping out of the ground. Of course, it's a video that's taken over a very long time, and we only see it, you know, a moment at a time, so it seems like some of the plants are popping out of the ground. But remember, this video is over a very long time and it was made very quick. But you can see how plants, they take a long time, but they slowly grow out of the ground and they make new green shoots. Okay. So our next word is mature, and this is a verb in this case. It can also be an adjective, but in this case it's a verb. To mature. To mature means to become fully grown. To become fully grown, to mature. So when a plant matures, it becomes fully grown. Now we can also, like I said, use that as an adjective. Adjective, of course, the abbreviation for adjective is that. And you can say, this is a mature tree. A mature tree. I'm sorry, cross my T. A mature tree. And that means that the tree is fully grown. That the tree is fully grown. Okay, so to mature, to become fully grown, it's also an adjective, a mature tree. Okay, next word is parent. Now, that's connected to the word we just studied, right? A mature tree is probably a parent tree. A parent is the father or mother of an animal, a plant, or a person. Now, plants don't really have mother and father like we think of in the animal kingdom, right? An animal, in the animal kingdom, a father is a male, a mother is a female, and they are the parents of their offspring, their children, and that is a parent. So the father and mother of an animal, a plant, or person. But you can also say, of course, for a tree, in this case, this tree, made the smaller tree grow, okay? So it is the parent of other trees in the neighborhood. Okay, so a parent. Next we have an adult. Wow, all these words are very similar. Mature, parent, adult, right? So adult is a fully grown animal or plant. And remember, an adult is a mature animal or plant. So an adult is an animal or plant that is fully matured. Okay. Young. Now, the opposite of mature, of parent, of adult is a young person or a young plant. Of course, baby is another way to say that, baby or child. So in this case, we have young. And interesting use of the word young here. It says young are the babies of an animal. So in this case, young is a noun, and we would probably say the young, right? The young of something. So those pups are the young of my dog. For example, those puppies are the baby of my dog. My dog had babies, and those are the young of my dog. So in this case, it's a little bit more of a scientific use. We don't usually use it in that way in general conversation. But it's okay. It's still common, but it's more of a scientific word or usage in this case. The young. Where is the young of a certain animal or plant, right? So the babies of an animal are the young. But of course, we also use young. We normally say young as an adjective, right? She is a young child. Or, of course, babies are young. That's what it means to be a baby, is to be young. Okay, so when I was young is a common saying. So it's an interesting word here, which is stage. Now, we've been talking about young and then adult or parent, but a young person or thing or animal or plant doesn't suddenly become an adult, right? There are different stages in that development. We have a good picture here of different stages. A stage is one part of a process. A process is how something happens. So how does a baby become an adult? Well, it goes through different stages, right? In this case, the plant is just a very young plant. We call it a seedling. It goes through different stages to become an adult plant. Think about the stages for you and I, right? We can say when we're born, right, we are a baby, right? But then we get a little bit older. Then we enter the next stage would be child, right? That's the next stage, child. The next stage after a child gets older, the child becomes what? A teenager. Okay, then after the teenager becomes older, right? What happens after the teenager becomes older? They become what? They become an adult, right? So these are different stages for humans and most animals, right? All animals. First, you're born as a baby, then you become a child, the next stage, then a teenager is the next stage, an adult is the next stage. So there are many different stages that living organisms, people, or animals and plants go through during their life. And that's just part of life. Okay, so interesting, stage. Okay, next one. Female. As I said before, we talked about parent, right? And I said father or mother. Now, a female is a mother, right? Mother is a female, and they belong to the sex that can produce a baby or an egg. So, females, in every species, every animal has male and female. The female is the one are the ones who can give birth to a baby. They produce eggs, and those eggs can grow into babies. Men don't have eggs, right? Men don't give birth to offspring. Only females do. So that's the female side, okay? Give birth. I just said give birth. Females give birth to young. Men do not give birth to young babies. Females give birth to babies. And give birth for a female animal to produce a baby from her body. All animals are born this way. The female who becomes the mother, right? She has an egg inside of her. It grows, it develops into a baby. The baby's inside of her. It has to get out. So when it's ready, not before, but when it's ready, hopefully not before, the baby will come out of the body of the female and there's a new baby. Whether it's a baby boy or a baby girl or a baby puppy or a baby cow, that's how animals are born. Their mothers give birth to babies. Okay, next we have tadpole. Probably, if you like to play outdoors, I don't know about many kids these days, but if you like to play outdoors, you probably see frogs. And if you see baby frogs, they look a lot different than adult frogs. Baby frogs look like little tadpoles. You know, go out into the, you know, if there's a mountain, trees, forest near where you live, after it rains, go out and look in the puddle of the water. Sometimes you see these little animals that look like this swimming around. These are called tadpoles, and they are a small creature with a long tail. They have long tails, and the little tail, you know, goes back and forth, and that's how they swim in the water, and it develops into a frog or a toad. And we have a video of many little tadpoles. This is what I'm talking about. Usually, you know, this looks a little bit larger, like a larger body of water. But when I was a kid, right, we could go out, we could see these little puddles of water, and we could see the little tadpoles. Let's look at them swimming around. You see their little tails are going back and forth. And sometimes we would catch the tadpoles, we would bring them home, put them in a jar of water, and we would watch them grow into frogs. And tadpoles are very interesting because they change completely. Well, one thing that happens with tadpoles, you see, is that their tail, right, the little tails that are going like this, they disappear, right? So over here on the left side of the picture, you see a baby frog, right? The tadpole is changing into the frog. It still has a long tail. But as it gets older, the tail will disappear. That means it becomes impossible to see, or it just goes away, right? In this case, the tail just goes away and you can't see it anymore. It happens over a long time, but it's very interesting. So that was something that we did as kids, you know. We would take tadpoles and watch them change into frogs. And of course, the amazing thing is their tails would disappear. So interesting. Okay, now it's time to talk about life cycles. Life cycles are for plants and animals. Every living thing goes through a cycle. Now, what does cycle mean? Cycle is like a circle, right? It starts at one point, it goes all the way around, and it comes back to the same point. And sometimes people call it the cycle of life, right? Natrenya. Oh, that's from Lion King, right? Okay, but that's what they're talking about in the very beginning of the Lion King, right? They're holding up the baby because that represents the cycle of life, the life cycle. We talked about that, different stages of life, right? You have a baby, child, teenager, adult, and then the adult gives birth to another baby and it starts again. And that is a life cycle. Life cycles happen for both plants and animals. As we can see on the plant side, right? First, we have a seed. That's stage one. In the first stage, there is a seed. Second stage, it grows up to a little seedling, right? And then third stage for trees, we call it a sapling. A sapling is like a teenager, I guess. And then finally, in the fourth stage, we have a fully adult mature tree, and the fully adult mature tree can give birth. It makes seeds, and these seeds spread out in the ground, and they grow again. So it's a cycle. For animals, it's very similar. We took the frog as an example, right? In the first stage, we can see eggs. The frog will lay eggs in the water, right? And those eggs will be fertilized and those eggs hatch, right? Frogs don't give birth, right? And that's, you know, that's getting into a bigger lesson. But reptiles don't give birth, they lay eggs, right? Mammals give birth, but that's a bigger lesson. So anyway, frogs will lay eggs, those eggs will hatch, and then in the second stage, we see that the tadpoles are turning into frogs. They still have the tail. They're still kind of a half tadpole, a little bit of a frog. And then in the third stage, they are young frogs. And then the fourth stage, they are adult frogs, mature frogs who are able to lay eggs of their own. So again, the cycle comes around full circle, makes a full circle, and that's the life cycle. So, okay, the circle of life. Okay, good. Okay, so we talked about plants, we talked about frogs. Let's take a look at another type of animal, or in this case, an insect. Now, an insect, a butterfly, do you like butterflies? They're very pretty, aren't they? And they're very beautiful to look at. Butterflies don't live long, though. It's kind of sad. Anyway, butterfly egg. Butterfly starts off as an egg. Most insects and reptiles start off as eggs. Of course, most mammals do too, except we don't see the egg. The egg is, in mammals, the egg is inside the female. But for reptiles and insects, they lay the eggs. We can see the eggs, and the eggs can exist or grow outside of the mother. Okay, so that's what happens here. We have a butterfly egg. Now, the butterfly egg will, when it hatches, when the baby comes out of the butterfly egg, it doesn't look anything like a butterfly. It's kind of ugly, and maybe some people might say, ooh, creepy, right? Gross. Maybe. It depends how you feel. But we call that the larva. All insects, when they hatch out of the egg, we call them larva. Interesting. And usually, many times, they don't look like the adults, right? They can look completely different. Now, a larva, its main job is to eat. It eats and eats and eats and it grows, right? After a certain time, it will form a cocoon or, some insects, they wrap themselves up in this silky type of web. And we call that stage the pupa, okay? And it just sits there, it just waits, you know, it's kind of conserving its energy, and over time it will slowly change. And then when it's ready, it comes out and it's the fully formed adult. And then we say it's an adult butterfly. So insects are pretty amazing, right? I mean, they completely change form during the different stages of their lives, right? These stages are very obvious, right? For human beings, you know, the stages are not that obvious, right? Of course, people are small and they get bigger, but they don't really change that much. I mean, they still have, you know, a head, two arms, two legs. It's not like they completely change and grow wings, right? Okay, but insects do. They completely change their bodies. So that's very interesting. Okay, well, that's it for that section. Next, let's take a look at the reading. Okay, are you guys ready for the reading? Let's read together, okay? And you can practice repeating after me or thinking in your head. Think about the pronunciation. Think about the words that we are using and highlight the vocabulary for this unit. You guys ready? Let's begin. Plants usually reproduce through seeds and grow in stages. First, a seed germinates and begins to grow. Roots come out of the seed. Then a stem grows up out of the ground. Next, the stem grows leaves. It now looks like its parents. As the plant grows and grows, it matures and becomes an adult plant. By contrast, interesting word there, interesting transition. By contrast, another phrase you can use on the other hand. On the other hand, if plants do this, on the other hand, animals, okay? Plants do this. By contrast, animals reproduce in several ways. Female mammals give birth to their young. So female mammals give birth to their young. The young look like their parents. The young grow and grow. They mature and become an adult. Humans, cats, and dogs are mammals. Of course, there are many other mammals, okay? Frogs are amphibians. Amphibian. Now, we didn't talk about that. That was not a word in our vocabulary section. What is an amphibian? An amphibian is an animal that can live in the water and out of the water, right? There are many types of amphibians, some lizards, newts, salamanders. They can live in the water, they can swim around in the water, and they also can live on land, but they usually have to be near water. They are amphibians. So frogs are amphibians. Their young are called tadpoles. They come out of an egg. They have a tail, but do not have legs. They look different from their parents, right? Mammals' young look like their parents. On the other hand, amphibian young do not look like their parents, okay? As they mature, they grow legs and the tail disappears. As an adult, they look like their parents. Okay, so interesting reading passage. We looked at trees, how they grow. Then we looked at mammals like humans, cats, and dogs. And we saw that when they grow, the babies look very similar to their parents, right? They look very similar. They don't really change. But amphibians like frogs, they do change. Their young look a lot different from the adults, so they change during different stages of their lives. So interesting reading passage. We looked at three examples of living things. Okay, let's take a look at the classification of the reading skill. In this case, the reading skill is the sequence. A sequence shows that something happens first and then what happens next and next. Remember we talked about stages and we talked about the life cycle, the circle of life? That is a sequence, right? And we saw in the cycle of life on that page, we had like four different stages. Okay, right? We had babies, you know, very young, then they change into something different, and then they become young adults, and then they become adults. But these are different stages. So sequence, 1, 2, 3, 4, first, second, third, fourth. This is a sequence of events. So let's take a look at the sequence. Here on the left side, we're talking about plants. On the right side, we're talking about female mammals. Okay, well, let's start on the left side with plants. And we have some blanks here. Plants grow in beep. A seed begins to first beep in the ground. So plants grow where? Plants grow in what? What do plants grow in? Well, if you think about it, where does the seed, can the seed, if you put it on a table, does it grow? No, it doesn't grow. It has to grow somewhere. It grows out of the ground. So plants grow in the ground. So plants grow in the ground. You have to put the plant in the ground for it to grow. A seed begins to first, remember at the very first part of the plant's life when we saw the plant coming up out of the ground, right? And we saw the video. The word that we learned there was germinate. 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 Do I have enough room? Yes. Whew. Germinate. Okay. Sorry, my handwriting. You can see the T and the E at the end. Germinate. A seed begins to first germinate in the ground, starts to grow. Then roots come out of the seed, right? If this is the ground, the seed is here, roots will grow down more into the ground, and a stem grows up out of the ground. So remember, there's two parts of a plant. You can't see the roots unless you take the plant and pull it up, right? Farmers will pull up the roots like carrots and potatoes and things like that. Then you can see the roots of the plant. So roots come out of the seed, then a stem. The stem is what you see coming up out of the ground, right? That's the part of the plant that we can see. That's the stem. grows up out of the ground. The stem, what happens with the stem? Well, on many plants, the stem will grow leaves to catch the sunlight. Later, it becomes an beep plant. Much later, you know, it grows fully, it's fully matured, it becomes an adult plant. Later, it becomes an adult plant. Okay, good. Those are plants. Okay, that's a sequence, right? First, second, third, fourth. In this case, yeah. Okay, so on the other hand, by contrast, we have mammals. Now, what happens with mammals? First, in the first age, female mammals beep to their young. Remember the vocabulary word we learned? Actually, it's two words, right? What do they do? What do women, what do females do that men don't do? Female mammals give birth. So they give birth to their young. Give birth. Oops, okay, my T's, maybe it's the pen, I keep missing the other side. Okay, give birth to their young. So female mammals give birth to their young. Next, the young look like their parents. They already look like their parents. They have a small, cute little head. Maybe they have their parents' eye color. Maybe they have their parents' hair color or the shape of the face. Many people say, oh, your baby looks just like you, right? Because mammals don't change really their shape or their body parts when they grow. They have a head, they have two arms, they have two legs, they don't have tails, nothing disappears, no new parts grow, right? They're like they are just smaller versions of their parents. Okay, so the young look like their parents, they begin to grow, right? The young, what do the young do? What is that process, the vocabulary word that we learned? What do young do to become an adult? They go through many stages, true, but as they go through those stages, what are they doing? They are maturing. So here we say the young mature. The young mature and become an adult, or become adults, depending on how you look at it. Okay, so the young mature and become an adult. So, those are the stages for mammals. On the one hand, we have plants. On the other hand, we have female mammals, and we can see the sequence of their growth, how they move through the different stages, and that is the cycle of life. Okay, do you want to watch The Lion King now? I kind of feel like that, or at least the first scene. Okay, good. Well, that's an interesting lesson. It's an interesting unit. But remember, all living things grow through stages. They all start off as young, and they mature and become adults, and they give life, or they reproduce, they make young to continue that cycle. So, very interesting lesson. Thanks for studying with me, and we'll see you next time. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.